Mr. President, it is a pleasure to be here in Poland. Indeed, we have been working together now for 8 years, become friends, and I really look forward also in the remainder of your term to work together on all these issues of our common security. Poland is a key security provider for the alliance, a steadfast supporter for Ukraine, and an important contributor to our collective defense. And I want to thank you for being also a leading supporter of Ukraine. You were one of the first allies to provide military aid. And since the start of Russia's full-scale invasion, Poland has welcomed over 1 million Ukrainian refugees and committed 4 billion euros in military aid. You host the NATO-Ukraine Joint Analysis, Training and Education Center. And I want to like to personally thank you for your leadership and steadfast support in these efforts. I was especially interested to hear about your recent visit to South Korea and your meetings with President Yoon. Putin's increasing reliance on Beijing, Pyongyang, and Tehran shows that our security is not regional, it is global. So we must step up our collaboration with our Indo-Pacific partners, including South Korea, Japan, Australia, and New Zealand. Today, we have discussed how to strengthen our support for Ukraine and fulfill the commitments allies made at the Washington Summit in July. This includes our financial pledge of 40 billion euros of military support in 2024, and also the new NATO command in Wiesbaden, which will coordinate security assistance and training. Allies at this moment, including Poland, are working hard to ensure that this command becomes fully operational as soon as possible, which will be crucial to strengthening Ukraine's defenses now and for the long term. As we look ahead to the next NATO summit in The Hague, we are also delivering on our commitments to further strengthen our deterrence and our defense. We are ramping up our defense industrial capacity, producing more shells, ships and missiles than we have done for decades. But we need to do more, and this was what our discussions concentrated on. We have to do more, faster, and I know that I can count on Poland to lead the way, including with your exemplary defense spending of over 4% of GDP, and even next year moving into the area of 4.7%. Because this sends a clear message, not only to our adversaries, but also to the United States, that Europe understands it must do more to ensure our shared security. And that starts with spending more and also fielding more capabilities. Another key priority for us is air and missile defense. And today, I was not able because of the visit of Secretary of State Tony Blinken to Brussels, but you have been at the official opening of the Aegis Ashore Ballistic Missile Defense Base in Retsikovo. This site significantly enhances our ability to defend against the growing threats of ballistic missiles from outside the Euro-Atlantic area. It is part of NATO's broader missile defense, which includes another Aegis Ashore site in Romania, US Navy destroyers out of Rota, Spain, and an early warning radar in Turkey. This new facility is a testament to the strong commitment of both the United States and Poland to our collective defense. Allies are also enhancing NATO's integrated air missile defense with new high-end capabilities to defend against threats from all directions, including air defenses and modern aircraft. And we are conducting large-scale air defense exercises like Ramstein Flak in Greece last month with more than 130 fighter jets and other aircraft from 12 NATO allies. So as we face growing threats, we are also strengthening our unity, our capabilities, and our resolve. Mr. President, dear Andrei, thank you again for your friendship, for your hospitality, and for Poland's commitment to our transatlantic alliance. Thank you.
Dziękuję serdecznie.